Hello, my name is Cheryl Clay, and I'm an environmentalist with the Alabama Department of Public Health. I'm here today to talk to you about the Zika virus. The Zika virus is primarily spread through the bite of an infected Aedes species mosquito. It's very important to be aware of the mosquito life cycle in order to protect yourself from mosquito bites. I want to talk to you about how the cycle starts. The Aedes species of mosquito that carries Zika virus actually prefers to lay their eggs in artificial containers that you may have around your home. So such as if we have this bucket here and you have a little bit of water in there, and it can be as little as a teaspoon of water that can attract and breed mosquitoes. The Aedes species of mosquitoes prefer to lay the eggs on the side of the container above the water line. Once the water reaches the eggs, either through a rain event or someone adding water, the eggs will hatch into the next stage, and then you will have larva. After the larval stage, we will have pupa, and then the adult mosquito emerges out of the water, out of the pupa, dries off, and flies away to look for a blood meal so she can have the protein that she needs to lay her eggs. So the best way to avoid a mosquito bite is to practice the three D's, which is drain, dress, and defend. So first of all, we're going to talk about drain, which is not to provide an environment for the mosquitoes to lay their eggs. So you do not want any standing water around your property for more than a few days that can cause a problem. So if you have any buckets or anything in your yard, you want to store them where they cannot collect water or keep them turned over. Do be aware though, if they do have this little lip on them, that this is enough area to hold water that could still breed mosquitoes. So you have to be aware of that. Another common breeding environment are tires. They really like tires. So you need to store your tires to where they will not collect rainwater. Or if you have something like a tire swing, you want to drain a hole in the bottom so when it rains, the water will drain out and not cause a problem for you. Another common breeding environment is your recycle bin. Now, although they have drain holes, if you have them clogged with leaves or any other type of debris that may cause them to collect water, they will breed a lot of mosquitoes over the course of the season. So be sure to keep those drain holes open to where the water can drain out. Other common areas to think about is your pet watering dish. You want to make sure to change the water out at least twice a week, if not more, and to scrub it out to remove any eggs, because this would be a common breeding environment. Also, we have the kiddie pools. Again, you want to keep those dumped out and scrubbed out twice a week. We do have a lot of folks that like to use these as a very large pet watering dish or as a bathing area for their pet. So we don't want to forget to keep this dumped out and scrubbed out as well. And then we also have common things in your yard, like a tarp or something like that, that you may have in the backyard covering wood or for any other purpose. But there's a lot of recessed areas that can collect water that a lot of folks don't think about. And it's very important to keep all of that drained out. Just this very week, we did find mosquitoes breeding in a tarp in the back of somebody's yard. So you just very important to be aware of that. Okay, a few other breeding environments to be aware of. The corrugated pipes. The little ridges in the pipes will collect and hold water, so it's very important that these are graded to drain, or we have holes drilled in the bottom so the water can drain out. Many people have flower pots in their yard. A flower pot must not be oversaturated with water. That can breed mosquitoes, so it's very important to have drain holes in those. And the little dishes are very common breeding environments. So we need to keep them dumped out and scrubbed out twice a week, or if you can, just eliminate them during mosquito breeding season. Another breeding environment to be aware of is natural environments such as fallen magnolia leaves. We have seen these breeding mosquitoes. Another natural environment to consider would be tree holes. You want to keep those filled with sand or mortar to prevent water from standing in there for too long. If you have a lot of debris in your yard, such as cans or bottles, these will be breeding environments as well as bottle caps. A lot of people aren't aware just something this small can breed a lot of mosquitoes if it's not kept drained out or preferably thrown away. We have our watering cans. A lot of people keep these outdoors during mosquito season. When it rains, we get water collected in here. These can be a bad problem, so don't forget to keep these drained out or stored where they cannot collect water. Another product I want to talk to you about, let's say you have a swimming pool that you're not operating, or a bird bath that's really heavy and hard to dump out, or even like this pot here that has the dish connected at the bottom. This is a mosquito larvicide. It is a natural control. It slowly releases a bacteria over 30 days that the immature mosquitoes feed on when they're in the water, and they'll die before the adult merges. They are safe for wildlife and pets, and it's you can purchase these at your local hardware store or any retailer that sells pesticides or online. So these are a good alternative if you do not are not able to dump out the water. Another thing to think about is you do not want the mosquitoes inside your home. So you want to have screening on your windows and doors to prevent the entry of the adult mosquitoes, because this type of mosquito species would love to come in your house and feed on you while you're asleep. So we've talked about the drain part of the three D's of drain, dress, and defend. So you know that you have addressed all breeding environments around your home, but you notice you're still having some adult mosquitoes in your yard. So again, you want to avoid the mosquito bite. So what you want to do is when you're outside, you want to wear your proper protective clothing. That's long sleeve shirt, long pants, light colored, because mosquitoes are attracted to dark colors. You want it to be loose fitting and tightly woven material to make it more difficult for the mosquito to bite you. The final part of the three D's is to defend. It's very important to wear a EPA registered insect repellent. That can include DEET, picaridin, IR3535, or oil of lemon eucalyptus. You want to make sure that you follow all label instructions, and that is very important. So again, the most important way to avoid Zika virus is to not receive a mosquito bite. So be sure to practice the three D's of drain, dress, and defend. Be sure to talk to your friends, your neighbors, your family to spread this information, or any other way that you can help in your community to get this information out so you can provide a safer environment for everyone in your area. If you would like additional information, please go to our website. And remember, the most important thing to do is to fight the bite.